So I told you BJT have three materials, SCR is having four materials. BJT will have two junctions. In SCR we have three junctions. The joining portion P and N joining is one junction, second junction, and this is the third junction. So we can see here the left side P-type material anode terminal is taken out, and the right side end N-type material cathode terminal is taken out. And this is the BJT I told, PNP is BJT. This is the base region of BJT where we will take gate terminal. So SCR is having three terminals, anode, cathode, and a gate terminal. Anode is taken from P-type material, cathode is taken from N-type material. Anode means positive and cathode means negative. And this is the base region of BJT. BJT plus one more N region together is called SCR. This is the base region of BJT. So we are taking gate terminal from the base region of BJT. So totally SCR is having three terminals, anode, cathode, and gate. This is the symbol of SCR. This is the symbol of SCR. You can see one diode is there and the gate terminal is taken out. A means anode and K means cathode. This is the symbol of SCR. And these are the different types of SCR packages. Practically, when we purchase, they will look like any of these types. These are the different types of SCR packages. Now coming to SCR, how it will work. You can see here the same four regions I am taking. PNP followed by N. PNP followed by N, four regions are available. This is junction 1, this is junction 2, this is junction 3. We are connecting P and N type material here. P and N type material here. No voltage, presently no voltage is applied. And the extremes, P type material and N type material are connected here. This is the supply. This is the supply voltage. This is the load resistance. And here gate voltage. This is called gate voltage. This no voltage is connected at the gate terminal. At the gate terminal, this is the supply voltage. So what happens when we take up a connection like this? Unless you give the supply voltage, unless you give the gate voltage here, if you are not giving any voltage, it is open circuited. At that point, J1 and J3 junction will be forward biased. J2 junction will be reverse biased. J1, J3 junction will be forward biased. J2 junction is reverse biased when no voltage is given at the gate terminal. No voltage is given at the gate terminal. Left side, it is anode terminal. Right side, it is cathode terminal. And from this base region, we are taking gate terminal. When the gate terminal is given no voltage, J2 junction is reversed bias, other two junctions are forward bias. In that case, no current flows. And in the entire circuit, no current flows. If at all we want any current to be allowed in the circuit, we should give a supply voltage greater than the breakdown voltage of the gate terminal. We should give supply voltage greater than breakdown voltage. But generally, breakdown voltage will be very, very high. So giving a supply voltage greater than breakdown voltage will be difficult. Okay. Whenever no gate voltage is given, we don't have any current flow in the circuit. So in order to make current flow in the circuit, we have to give supply voltage greater than the breakdown voltage. Here some breakdown means open circuit, breakdown voltage. We should give supply voltage greater than the breakdown voltage. Generally, breakdown voltage itself, breakover voltage itself will be very high. So giving a supply voltage greater than the breakover will be difficult. So this method is not followed generally. Instead, what we will do, we will give small voltage at the gate. Instead of no voltage, we will start giving small voltage at the gate terminal. At that point, still J2 will be reverse bias, J3 will be forward bias, and N-type material, electrons will flow from right to left. And holes, P-type material holes will flow from left to right. At the J3 junction, electrons will flow from right to left. Holes will flow from left to right. There will be a small current flow in the gate terminal. There will be a small current flow in the gate terminal. How we are taking up? The second case is, we will give a small voltage at the gate terminal. Instead of no voltage, we will start giving a small voltage. At that point, J3 forward bias, J2 reverse bias, that is maintained the same. And the electrons will be moving from right to left. Holes will be moving from left to right at the J3 junction. because of this current will start flowing in the gate terminal. Small current will start flowing in the gate terminal. This will happen for a little while, and as the gate current, small gate current is there, the anode side, anode terminal also will have small current flowing. Anode terminal also will have small current flowing. So slowly there is gate current, slowly there is anode current. Two currents are flowing, and this will happen for a while, and extremely within a small time, junction J2 will break down and the SCR will conduct heavily. Okay, so what happens, the gate current will be very small, anode current also will be very small. Initially it will be very small value, but within short time the junction J2 it will break down, and there will be a heavy flow of current, heavily conduction will take place in the SCR, and the graph will look like this. You can see in the first quadrant, initially there is a small current flow. Okay, y-axis value, it is very less y-axis value for a small amount of time. After that, when junction J2 reaches breakover voltage, there is a sudden increase in the current. Okay, y-axis value, there is a sudden increase in the current. And this state, very small current, then breakover voltage, then on state current, gate current will become zero. This is the anode current. Okay, and this first quadrant graph we will see in the software. There are two methods to switch on the SCR. One method is with no gate voltage, giving supply voltage greater than the breakover voltage. Okay, first method is giving supply voltage greater than breakover voltage, but that is not preferable because breakover voltage will be very high. So giving a supply voltage greater than the breakover is difficult. The second method, we will give small gate voltage and we will see that there is gate current flowing. Because of that, anode current also starts flowing. But within a short time, there will be heavy conduction in the SCR, and we can reduce that heavy current only by reducing the supply voltage. Heavy current flow in the SCR. Okay, so all these are the points which are related to SCR. What I have explained is available here. So SCR can work in two conditions. When no gate voltage is given, there is no current flow, that is called off switch. No current flow means that is called off switch. In the other case, heavy current flow, that is called on switch. SCR can conduct or heavily conduct. Only two possibilities for the SCR. So it will work as a switch. Okay, when no gate voltage, no current flow. When there is small amount of gate voltage, within a small time, there is heavy current flow. So those two are the conditions. SCR will be working as a switch. Okay, these are the things related to SCR. These are some of the terminologies related to SCR. And here you can see SCR can also work as a half wave rectifier. Here, when you give small gate voltage, approximately 5 volts, you will get the current or voltage as half wave rectifier. Flowing in the forward path at the anode. Whatever current is flowing at the anode, it will be like half wave rectifier. Voltage also looks like half wave rectifier waveform. Okay. So there are some points which you can go through. For Viva, we may ask some of the points related to SCR. You can go through it. Okay, SCR related things. With this theory, in the software, we will try to see the half-wave rectifier waveform. In the software, PSPICE, we will try to see the half-wave rectifier waveform using SCR. And secondly, we also will see the current conduction in SCR, how the current conduction, first quadrant preferably, we will check in the software.